Hello, how are you? Hope you are doing well. Welcome to our channel if you are new. If you have watched any of our other video, welcome back to Geography Nuts. We are going to explore another small state in the Caribbean today. Have you heard of Antigua and Barbuda? It is in the Lesser Antilles and part of the Leeward Island. The country includes two bigger islands, Antigua and Barbuda. They are about 63 kilometers apart and few smaller islands. Some of these smaller islands are owned by clubs and wealthy individuals. This country has some interesting neighbors. St. Kitts and Nevis, a small independent state, very similar to Antigua and Barbuda. They have some cultural and historical connection and they are pretty friendly. I have a video and I will put the link in the description and highly recommend watching that next. Then you will have Anguilla and Montserrat. Both of them are United Kingdom's overseas territory. And finally, St. Barthélemy and Guadeloupe. Both of these islands are French territory. Capital and the largest city is St. John's and is located in Antigua. For administrative purposes, Antigua is divided into six parishes. Barbuda and Redonda are considered dependencies. Let's go look at the flag. I do like their flag. This is Antigua and Barbuda's flag. The V-shaped cutout in the red means victory at last. The seven-pointed golden sun symbolizes the dawn of the new era. The red symbolizes the lifeblood of the slave and the forefathers of the country. Blue symbolizes hope and the sea. White symbolizes the land. Black symbolizes the soil and the African heritage. This is the coat of arms and it is full of symbols like most other coat of arms. The pineapple on the top represents the famous Antigua's black pineapple. The red hibiscus flower around the pineapple symbolizes the many varieties of flowers that bloom in the island. The golden sun and the wavy blue and white bands on the shield symbolizes the sea, sun and the beaches. The sugar mill tower and the stem of the sugar cane gives a nod to its historical sugar industry. The century plant or the dagger pole with the stem and yellow flowers was part of the historical emblem of Antigua and the Leeward Island. Another historical nod. Two deers on the side of the shield depict the only large animal within the Eastern Caribbean and that is unique to Antigua and Barbuda. Finally, the scroll with the country's motto, each enduring, all achieving. Is that enough symbolism for you? Let's move on to
geography.
It is a small country. Actually, it is the 14th smallest country in the world with an area of about 443 square kilometers. The larger island is Antigua and the smaller one is Barbuda. Coastline of both of these islands are intricate with bays, beaches, lagoons, natural harbors and headlands. Shoreline is fringed with coral reefs, but the interior of the island is mostly flat and made up of limestone base rather than volcanic rocks and lava. Mount Obama is the highest peak with a height of about 402 meters. It is used to be known as Boggy Peak, but it was renamed in 2009 to honor the President Barack Obama and to recognize him as the symbol of black achievement. But I couldn't find any record of Obama visiting these islands. There are no rivers in the island. Few streams run short distance only. Both islands lack fresh groundwater. There are no notable natural lakes either. Potsworks Reservoir function as a source of water for domestic and agriculture use. Antigua is known as the land of 365 beaches, one beach for every day of the year. Barbuda is the coral island with stunning pink sand beach. As you can guess, the climate is tropical, but not too hot or humid because of the northeast trade wind. However, it doesn't rain much because there are no mountains to stop the cloud. Rainfall averages about 1000 millimeters per year, mostly rain between September and November, drought is a common problem. Temperature ranges from 23 degrees Celsius in the winter between December and February, that is, and 30 degrees in the summer. Hurricanes strike on an average about once a year between July and October. Let's go check out
people and culture.
Total population is about 96,000, making it the 13th smallest country. About 94,000 live in Antigua and they are called Antiguan. Only 2,000 people live in Barbuda and they are called Barbudan. Quarter of all Antiguan live in the capital, St. John's. Most Barbudan live in Codrington. It is the largest town in Barbuda. Most of them are either black or mulatta, descends from West African slave. The largest minority group is mixed race because of all the mixed marriages. The second minority group is white, mostly British descent. Finally, the remainder of the population is mix of many other race, mainly from East India and other Asian countries. Regardless of the race, most of them are Christians, particularly Anglicans. It is important to note that about 15% of the island population is from other English-speaking countries such as United States of America, United Kingdom or Canada, or from other English-speaking Caribbean islands like Jamaica, Dominica or Guyana. Most of these people live in either English Harbor or Jolly Harbor. English is the official language, but Antigua's Creole is slightly different from English. Many of the words came from English, but few of them came from other African languages. Barbudan accent is slightly different from Antiguan's. Calypso music was created by slaves to communicate with each other. It is still popular in the island along with reggae. Cricket is the famous sport like many other British colonies, but in Antigua, they play everywhere and all the time. Even though it is a small country, it produced 4 world-class cricket players. We are done with people and culture and it's time for
history.
Antigua was first inhabited by Siboney people as far back as 3000 BC. Then Arawak came from Venezuela around 1200 BC. They brought new crops like pineapple, corn, tobacco and cotton. And then the Kalingo, also known as the Carib, settled into the island around 800 AD. Christopher Columbus spotted this island on his second voyage in 1493 and named the bigger one Antigua after iconic church in Spain, Santa Maria de la Antigua, and named the smaller one Barbuda, which means bearded in Spanish. There are no record of why he chose this name. It could be either that he saw a bearded fig tree like these ones, or he may have seen a bearded Kalingo native man on the island. Columbus found the islands, named the islands, but Spanish didn't settle in these islands as they already had larger islands to settle and conquer in the Caribbean region. But the English settlers from St. Kitts started a new settlement in Antigua in 1632. Christopher Codrington started a sugar plantation in Antigua in 1674. 10 years later, he leased Barbuda from British and expanded his plantation to Barbuda and imported African slaves to work in the plantation. After almost 150 years of slavery, slaves in Antigua was freed in 1834 after few uprisings. However, the freed slave had little choice as they didn't have any land or money. So they worked on the plantation that they were slaving for very little money or food and shelter. So the poor working condition continued. To help the workers, unionists started Antigua Labour Party with Vere Cornwall Bird as a president in 1946. Later, this party became a major political entity and laid the way for independence. The fight for independence started slowly, so British set up a West Indies Federation to administer the British Caribbean territories Antigua and Barbuda was part of this between 1956 and 62. That wasn't enough, so Antigua and Barbuda became a self-governing state within British Commonwealth in 1967. Britain retained control over defense and foreign affairs. And subsequently, Antigua and Barbuda became a fully independent country on November 1, 1981. Finally, the two decades after the independence, politics was dominated by the Byrd family and Antigua Labour Party. It provided a degree of political stability and boosted tourism. But Byrd government was frequently accused of corruption, cronyism, smuggling illegal weapons, and drug trafficking. Hurricane Lewis hit the islands in 1995 and destroyed 75% of the homes and set back almost 10 years of development. 4 years later, Hurricane Jose hit the island and caused extensive damage. Then in 2017, Hurricane Irma hit both islands but destroyed 95% of Barbuda's building and infrastructure, leaving Barbuda barely habitable. All of the Barbudans were evacuated to Antigua before the Irma hit the islands, leaving Barbuda empty for the first time since the colonization started. Most of the residents had returned to the island now, but they are still struggling. This is the end of history. Let's go check out
economy.
Antigua and Barbuda's GDP is 2.7 billion. It ranked 173rd in the world, and the GDP per capita is $29,000. Official currency of Antigua and Barbuda is Eastern Caribbean dollar. It is pegged with United States dollar, so United States dollar also widely accepted and used. Tourism dominates the economy, contribute to more than half of the GDP. Antigua is famous for its luxury resorts and ultra-high-end accommodations. Investment banking and financial services also make up an important part of the economy. Many major world banks have offices in Antigua. The U.S. Securities and Exchange Commission has accused Antigua-based Stanford International Bank of orchestrating a huge fraud. As a result, government has made some changes to their financial structures. Agriculture is focused on local consumption only. It is limited by the water supply and labor shortage. Most people prefer to work in hospitality or construction as it pays more. Manufacturing sector is very small. It contributes very little to the economy. They do some assembled exports, such as producing bedding and handcraft items, as well as some electronics components. American University of Antigua College of Medicine is another source of revenue. The university employs many local Antiguans, and approximately 1,000 students attend the university. Antigua and Barbuda also uses the economic citizenship program and attract wealthy high income earners, as they don't have to pay income tax. If you're from Antigua and Barbuda, I would love to hear from you. Please put your comment, doesn't matter what it is, positive or negative, in the comment. And I love reading it. Even if you are not from Antigua, I would love to hear from you and hope you learn something new about this wonderful country. I always include history in this video as I think it's very important to know the history so you can understand the people, culture, and how the country came to be. Don't you agree? If you like this video, please press the thumbs up button and let me know. And if you like to learn more about other countries in the Caribbean and continue on to South America, please subscribe to this channel. So when we put a new video, you will get a notification. Thank you for watching and see you next time.